Good morning to all of you. You must be worried by now, right? And maybe you have a question, and the question could be, do these particles really affect my life, my health, my immune system? Well, that's a question we cannot definitely answer by now, because do means that we need to have information about exposure. But definitely, these particles can affect our immune system. Therefore, we have a lot of proof. Proof from, for instance, air pollution, like the person said just right now. Well, here you see what can happen if you expose immune cells to plastics. These are polystyrene particles in red, and in green you see the dendritic cells. And dendritic cells are important cells in the immune system. They function as some kind of sentinels, trying to sense what's in their environment and eventually also clear their environment from all the stuff that's around. Here you see two examples. One on your left is a big particle. And you see that the dendritic cell in green tries to get around this particle. Maybe it's already taken up, but we're not sure. What this cell maybe will do is try to engulf it further, but it will be choked up, right? And then it probably dies again. The particle released again, and other cells will come and try to do the same thing. The other cells, they have little particles already engulfed in their cytoplasm, or in sort of vesicles, and they might be a little bit tickled. They may be activated. They cannot resolve this problem. Normally, they have the machinery to degrade bacteria, but they don't have the machinery to degrade these particles. So they will remain probably in these cells. And these cells still want to degrade these particles and get frustrated and produce all kinds of molecules that activate other cells to come and help. So there will be probably an inflammation. That's what we assume from these particles. But actually, from airborne particulates, we know that they can induce an inflammation. Here you see lung tissue of a mouse exposed to particulate matter that we collected in the environment. And we installed it 16 hours before we took this picture from the lungs. And you see in the middle, you see this dark stuff. It's a precipitation, I think, of black matter. It's surrounded by cells. And if you look carefully, these are inflammatory cells. And even in the other picture, you see these little cells, they are really inflammatory cells. So indeed, in these mice, we can induce inflammation with these particles that we collected from outside. We also did studies with polystyrene in the same model. We couldn't, of course, see these particles. They are not easy to find if they are not labeled or whatever. But if we treated these mice, we could find inflammatory responses as well. And also, if we co-expose these mice to a protein, we can find allergic responses to that protein. So we can make these mice allergic with polystyrene particles, as we can with these particles. So indeed, particles can affect your immune health. Whether they do is a question still, and depends on exposure assessments, but we know this already. We know that there's an increase of inflammatory cells also in humans that are exposed. And we did these studies in the Netherlands a while ago when we asked volunteers to cycle on a bicycle on different locations. So they were in a stop-and-go location, they were also on a truck traffic location, and this person on the picture is on the subway station in Amsterdam, at Schiphol. And they were allowed to cycle for 5 hours, 20 minutes per hour, and then we collected blood, and we found an increase in these individuals of 30% of neutrophils, which are leukocytes that are involved in inflammatory responses. So we could see this response 2 hours after the last cycling of these individuals. The day after, the cells were at normal level again. But we didn't know, and still don't know, what happened with these particles. Did they wander around in our body? Did they go to the liver or the spleen and wait for other particles to join and to accumulate and maybe have a long-lasting effect? That is something we do not know. And we do not know exactly the uptake, but the question could also be, do we need information about uptake, or is it sufficient to know whether the particles get into our lungs? As we have seen in the picture, these lungs will be activated to induce inflammation or to raise inflammation. You see these inflammatory cells in the lungs. These particles were not yet taken up. In this case, you see an intestinal lining. These are cells of the intestine. And we have exposed these cells to these red polystyrene particles. And here you can imagine in this picture that some of these cells are really covered by plastics. So they wouldn't feel too happy, I guess, and also produce all kinds of molecules that trigger immune responses. We are not yet sure whether they do, but we have indications that indeed these epithelial cells of the gut will become activated, as also is happening in the lungs. Well, as I said and others said before, Dick, and we need more information about exposure because, as you know, hazard is multiplied by exposure, is risks. And I'm really happy that we have an EU project granted a year ago, and I'm heading this together with Heather Leslie. And in this project, this polyrisk project, we are going to study the relation between human exposure and effects on the immune system. And it's a real nice project where we can do interdisciplinary work. I can work on the immune system with a team of researchers, and Heather can look for the exposure. So hopefully in the end we have this knowledge that we really can decide the risk. And we will do that. We will estimate this risk in human scenario studies. And here are the examples that we want to study. For instance, we would like to study what happens in textile industry. And I bet, that's the guess, that in this situation there's a high exposure to fibers from textile. We also will do a study in Norway in indoor soccer playgrounds. And they have indoor playgrounds because it's dark and in the winter they still want to play soccer. And these are artificial playgrounds. So that is a study we will do. We will also look to effects of car exhaust, traffic-related particles, and also in rubber factory. And also we like to know what happens if we drink water. Are we really exposed to nanoplastics and microplastics? Well, this is one study. We are also happy to collaborate within Momentum and with Aurora. And in particular, Aurora and Polyrisk are part of a European group of projects, consortium of projects called CUSP. And you can look on the internet, you find the link. If you Google for CUSP, you will find the five projects that will collaborate together to at least get a clue in the end whether we are really at risk, our immune system is really at risk. Thank you for your attention.